is the government also. The AICT, once upon a time said the engineering should have 50 acres. Then they come down to 25 acres. Again they come down to 18 acres. Now I think the 7.5 acres. Even in 7.5 acres, we have unused land. I suggested the CITCO secretary, and we are ready to give some land or building to start industry. Mr. Ravi, please note. We are ready to give land to start industry. Suppose if you want to start industry, you come to my college, you can start industry. We are, land is very important factor for any industry. And buying land is also very costly. You need not invest some lakhs and crores. Land is available. Even one step further, I suggested we also erect shed also. You give minimal rent for the college. So if the industry atmosphere is provided in engineering college, core industries or software, see each and IT people, each and every engineering college, there are more than 500 computers are lying idle after 3 p.m. Every day. And every weekend, these computers are idle. All lab machineries are idle. But each lab is converted as a small industry. Then by seeing that, how the people are working, the students also will be attracted. And they will have on-hand training, and they have very good interaction, that triple I, that is industry institution interaction. In the college itself, see, we cannot ask the industry people to come to college, and we cannot, it's very difficult to, my dear Ravi, maybe very, very difficult to take boys and girls from college to industry. So they are disturbing industry people. When they visit, go for visit, they are disturbing industry people. And they don't like, there are many industries, they don't allow students, engineering students, to enter into the industry. Just they go to industry, they see the outside building and all, they come back. So these are all various points, I think you can include the tips to attract students for engineering college. Already suggested that another guy that each course you should highlight the scope of the study locally, grow nationally, and do your service globally. That type of concept you should cultivate among the students. So then only, as my friend like this said, like that, without engineers, no economy can survive in the world. Engineering service is very, very essential service for economic growth of any country. But nobody realizing that. Many people are coming to the engineering college to get good job. That is not the course. Our late president of India, Abdul Kalam, wherever he goes, he used to advise that every engineering student should become an entrepreneur. It is possible, not by individual, but by the government only. This is another add value point. So when government wants to create so many entrepreneurs, what about this policy, industrial policy? No infrastructure, no road, no current, no water, no transport. How can you encourage entrepreneurs? There is another threat from income tax, GST, service tax. How can you generate entrepreneurs? Therefore, you see, the people want to go to some companies with a dappa of Thai Sadam and come back safely, getting salary of a minimum 50 to 1 lakh. Safe. Therefore, there are so many points, my dear Ravi, to discuss about how to develop the engineering college. Unless otherwise, you change the atmosphere of engineering college as an industry, it is very, very difficult to attract students to study engineering. This is main point.
I have an interesting statistics to share with you. If you go to the matrimony.com, tamilmatrimony.com, the most popular sought-after bridegrooms and brides are engineering background. So engineers are desirable, desired, and they do get settled in life.
So this is to add to Madam CEO and Sir. Madam was much worried about placements in core sector. It's not happening. First of all, I'll add on to Sir. Life is engineering. There is no second thought in that. Either it be MBBS or any stream of study, life is engineering. So if you look at the statistics, 25% of students who enter an engineering college, they land up in campus placement with high colors. So that is one score which pulls all engineering admissions even now. As Sir right now pointed out, even in matrimony, engineers are preferred. So engineers are preferred than doctors. For a doctor to prove, he has to complete his 6 years of MBBS, then he has to go pay some crores and get inside MD, and that is the scope. An engineering guy with a good placement, I came across one offer which says 29 lakhs per annum. Amazon is looking for 2018 graduates with 29 lakhs per annum. So that is the scenario now. So engineering, always there is scope. Madam was very much worried about placements in core sector. Of course, as I raised this point yesterday, mechanical industry, they blindly tell me, sir, we need diplomas. Then I have to tell them, sir, I will give you engineering graduates, you give them diploma salary. Because the salary level is 15,000 rupees. So the standard salary for mechanical graduates is, they say, 10,000, 12,000, free accommodation, free food. So that is the scenario. So they say, sir, we feel that for diploma holders, we can give lesser salary and make them. My suggestion, madam, since you are in management, what strategy I have for this core sector is, students of these core sectors can be targeted for higher studies. Because whenever we think about accreditation or any other quality audit in our institution, they ask us, what is the percentage of students being placed? What are the percentage of students being driven for higher studies? So students in core sector, they can be targeted for higher studies, maybe for an MBA program. Again, like similar to engineering, MBA has wide scope in placement. You believe it or not, I have a dual profession. One profession is director management studies. I have a lot of demand, but I'm not able to meet out the supply. Daily they're asking, sir, is there MBA marketing students available? MBA marketing students available. That is the talk. Okay, so for MBA, the placement scope for MBA is tremendous. But only thing is, it is not a white collar job. They have to be on field, they have to achieve the targets, etc., etc. But they get more salary than engineering graduates. So Baiju's salary package is somewhere around 6 to 8 lakhs per annum, which is better than average salary of engineering graduates. So these mechanical, civil, electrical engineering graduates can be targeted for higher studies. That may lead to entrepreneurship, as sir said. Entrepreneurship is a dimension which is still unexplored in most of the institutes. We have entrepreneurship development cell, but the next question is, how many entrepreneurs you have developed? The answer is a big question mark. We don't have answer for that. But when committee comes, we have to pull down some family entrepreneurs' data. So that also can be given a dimension. EDI Ahmedabad, they have an MBA program in entrepreneurship. And I am making them a request to have that MBA program in campuses, but it's not happening. So my conclusion is, engineering education has a very good scope, irrespective of many memes. Okay, there are many memes on engineering education also. Irrespective of many memes, there is wide scope for engineering education. Engineers in core sector can be targeted for higher studies. So I think most of the institutes, we have MBA programs also. We have MBA programs. If possible, management can give at a concessional fare for these engineering graduates who are very well in core sector for MBA education. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. 1 minute, sir. I think so far we have touched upon in a very purposeful manner perception about engineering that needs to be improved in a general way, though I think most of us here are convinced that engineering is very sought after and very useful profession for economic development and so on. The second point you have touched upon is ambience of engineering colleges must be better. Of course, there are also other suggestions and so on. I think it's time to move on because we have limited time and we need to cover a wide ground. So I would request Jayanti to flag the next suggestion.
I'd just like to add one point. There is a department called the MSME department, and they also have, it's an All India presence, and we have one in, right here, yes. And the observation made by them was, they fund certain projects where the colleges are expected to work with the local industry. Local means very close. They had a limit of 8 kilometers, 20 kilometers, depending on the location. It was different for different places. And these colleges, of course, with the help of their professors, would visit these, it's also funded, they give some money also, for the first year or second year, and thereafter they say it should be self-sustaining. You have to visit these industries and they ask them to solve their problems. Manufacturing, painting, welding, I mean various issues. There are not much of software. This is more of the other than software streams. So these colleges work with the industry and then they build a knowledge bank of all the problems they face. These problems are highly local. Like Bengal has different problems. Even in Tamil Nadu, each location has different problems. Maharashtra, these are better states, Rajasthan, Maharashtra, Gujarat. So what happens is the knowledge bank is available to the local entrepreneurs. And once the local entrepreneurs are getting the consulting or advisory at a very low cost or zero cost, because the first 2 years the funding is done by the government, then the college starts charging small consultancy. What they said was most of the places where they have funded the project, after the first 2 years when the funding has stopped, the college was not continuing that procedure. So the local industries are not benefiting from the knowledge of the faculty and the students, and the students are not getting the benefit of the practical issues in the industry. I just thought I'd share it. This is from the MSME point of view. Thank you.
Do we have any idea in internship?
Mistakes, no?
Yeah, yes, sir. Mistakes also. Yes.
Mistakes is very important. No? If once you.
Okay, just.
Mistakes, that, then automatically.
Just you're touching upon that, where you're going wrong or something like that. To my knowledge, I'm being proud to be as an engineer, as a student, as an educator, as an head of the institution, and also now part of administration. We can go compensate this in the engineering industry last 40 years, three phases. When I studied as an engineering, especially take example of Tamil Nadu, there are only 1,600 seats. So 1984, the first phase of self-financing came into existence. The second phase, 96 to 99, the third phase. If you see that growth, somebody was telling about morning the exponential. The exponential growth was from 2004 to 2007. Sudden spurt of engineering colleges, not only in Tamil Nadu, in southern India. So here, many of the owners are here, CEOs are there. I'm sorry to say if I'm saying something different one. So we, as an engineer, 2009 to 2013, we reaped heavily. But suddenly, there was a downtrend. Because of the, sometimes we represented the management, we as a management represented the government, the policy was different. So every college was, there was a restriction till from 84 to 2004. A college can admit only 300 students or 420 students. After that, they should get accredited. They should have their own evaluation. But suddenly all this was gone. All the colleges are increased their strength double time, sometimes some institutions triple time also. So we have digged our own grave for that 3 to 4 years. So 2012-13, it was a peak time. Almost all the 488 colleges filled up all the seats. That time 214,000 students were there, 184 times were admitted. But suddenly, the last 5 years was growth down. Maybe now we feel hue and cry saying that admission not there. But definitely still, engineering will success, but we have to be a little bit patient. So there are small mistakes in between administrations and establishment. Somebody says, some point of attraction people are doing it. Maybe it definitely will be success, as I said this. Thanks for that.
I will add, it's also one point of mistake only, no? The engineering college is very essential one, but the AICT and the state government, without analyzing the impact of more number of engineering colleges, they are very liberal in granting approval of engineering colleges. Already one engineering college is in one place. So the government should study whether another engineering college is required in that region or not. So we are not discouraging. But now the engineering colleges are suffering, no? They have invested some crores. I'm very sorry to say there are more than 100 colleges. Each college, 10 crores means what about the heavy amount of money invested, the waste? They are going to close engineering colleges. Why? The government makes these entrepreneurs to suffer. So before that, government should have restricted, yes, Ramla district, this number of engineering colleges only, Virudhunagar district, this number of colleges only. Like that, it should earmark. And another mistake, the government, AICT, Anna University allowed all colleges to start mechanical engineering, civil engineering, electronics engineering, computer engineering. Therefore, there is huge supply of this type of engineers than the requirement. This is another big mistake they have done. They allowed very liberally affiliation for engineering colleges without seeing the region-wise requirement and industry background, and also granting approval for the courses, similar courses in all colleges. I'm very sorry, we are not against Deemed University. Deemed University is having liberal policy. They can start any course and they can admit any number of students. But whereas affiliated colleges, they're restricted. The affiliated colleges cannot start any course and they cannot increase the strength. So therefore, same students from Tamil Nadu, eligibility for Deemed University is different. Eligibility for affiliated colleges is entirely different. So a lot of mistakes than the government side and as well as the management side. Once this is rectified, naturally engineering college will survive.
Yeah, thank you. Another thing is elaborate answer.
Faculty members also qualified, but not technically qualified.
I think I have not been understood correctly. And Professor Kanagaraj has been very systematic and elaborate about various points. Very well said, very well recorded also. I am asking one question, sir. I want to tell me, when Indian cricket was very low, they brought in a foreign coach. They brought in T20. They brought in one-day matches. And cricket became very successful. Have you brought in an idea in your college which made your popular college attract more number of students? Or have you made a mistake which shooed away students away from your college? I want to tell your own college's examples. The problems with the AICT, UGC, government interference is all known to us. What I want to ask is, what is it that you have done to attract more talent? I hope my question is better understood now.
We are all gathering here to receive some of the solution for our problems. Finally, I am coming to the point. We have discussed many things. We have discussed many...
It's turned on.
Hello? Namarode problem abdina, we are gathering only the small and medium colleges here, I think. For tier 1 colleges, why we are gathering here? To receive some of the solution for our problems. What is the main problem? Admission. Why? We have spent a lot of money to get the admissions. Even we have provided cash to the students. 10,000 per seat, 15,000 per seat, even 25,000, 30,000 per seat, even though it is not possible to attract the students. Many of the colleges not unfilled, which is located in the rural area. அதாவது தமிழ்நாட்டில் அது சார் சொன்னார், அருமையாக சொன்னார் சார். அதாவது இந்த என்ஜினியரிங்னுடைய அந்த ஃபீல்டு, மீம்ஸ்லையாக இருக்கட்டும், சோசியல் மீடியா தான் இதை ஸ்பாயில் பண்ணிச்சு. டு பி ஃப்ராங்க், மீம்ஸ் போகிறது யார், ரெண்டு பேர் ஓர சுற்றிட்டு இருக்கானே, அவன் என்ஜினியரிங் ஸ்டூடெண்டாக இருப்பான்பா. சைன் எடுத்துகிட்டு போயிட்டான், ஆமாம் என்ஜினியரிங் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்டு. ஒரு காலத்தில் எவ்வளோ ஒரு ஃபேமஸாக இருந்த ஒரு கோர்ஸு, டாக்டர் அப்துல் கலாம் சொன்னார்னு நான் இந்த காலேஜ் ஆரம்பித்தேன். பெரிதாக கனவு காணுங்கள்னார், ஒரு என்ஜினியரிங் காலேஜ் கட்டலாமேனு கட்டினேன். ரொம்ப ஸ்ட்ரகிள் ஆகிட்டுருக்கு. நீங்கள் இஃப் யூ கோட்டு த கொங்கு பெல்ட், கோயம்புத்தூர், சேலம், ஈரோடு, ஸோ மெனி காலேஜஸ் இன் இ சேம் ஏரியா. Nearly about 17 colleges which is located in our area, within 2 districts. More than 17. Sultan sir. Satyam College of Engineering and Technology. ஸோ நான் வி ஆர் ஃபேஸிங் ஒன்லி எங்களுக்கு எல்லா பிரச்சனையும் சால்வ் ஆகிடும், அட்மிஷன் மட்டும் ஆகிட்டால் சால்வ் ஆகிடும். ஸோ அதுக்கு இந்த ப்ரோக்ராம் ஆர்கனைசரு எங்களுக்கு ஒரு நல்ல சொல்யூஷன் சொல்லுங்கள். ஏன்னா நாங்கள் சொல்யூஷன் தெரியாமலாம் இங்கே வரல, எங்களால் முடிஞ்ச அளவுக்கு நாங்கள் பண்ணி பார்த்துட்டோம்.